Simmers, welcome back to Behind the Sims, our community series dedicated to giving you peeks into all that is happening across the Sims franchise. In case we haven't had the pleasure, I'm Mercy from the Sims team, and I'm back at it again with all the exciting news and latest updates on what's going on behind the scenes, starting with The Sims 4. Ah! Attention, Simmers! This is not a drill! This is not a drill! Get ready, because the new season is starting, and if you're like me, you're hungry to learn more. So, let's take a look at some of the stuff the team's been cooking up in The Sims 4.
Stuff packs. It's been a while. Well, I'm happy to share that there's a new stuff pack on the menu, and it's my privilege to introduce you to just a few of the newest members of Maxis that are developing it.
Tervetuloa, Simmers. Welcome. This is your first look at the Sims 4 Home Chef Hustle Stuff Pack. The team has been hard at work to bring this pack to life. Our new teammates in Europe have been working closely with longtime members of the Sims team to learn about and innovate on how we make packs. You'll see lots of new faces today, but some familiar as well, like Graham and Cheyenne, who's going to talk about the art direction of Home Chef Hustle.
Artists and I were inspired by the beautiful kitchens in various areas of Europe and reference shared with us from our EU teammates. We wanted to bring some new colors and fresh new objects in addition to our new appliances. Also ingenious things that we don't have here in North America, like a dish drain over the sink.
There is a whole lot of stuff in this stuff pack. New small appliances, new ways to make money, new ways of cooking, new BB, new casts, and so much more. Listing it all here and now would be a bit of a mouthful, but the team and I know the perfect feature to start with.
When your sim wants something quick, but delicious, for breakfast, brunch, or dessert, the waffle maker is the perfect appliance. With this feature, we wanted to represent the Nordic style of waffle that I and some of my other teammates grew up with. It's a quite thin and crispy waffle, and it's usually made in a waffle iron that produces heart-shaped waffles.
We have included a variety of flavors, from some more typical Nordic-inspired flavors, like cured fish and dill, to some more familiar to our North American friends, like chicken and waffles.
We've added so many recipes from many cultures over the years, but over time, the recipe list has become a little trickier to use. So, we've heard you, and we've added filters to the base game recipe list, so you can now find the meal you're looking for in a fraction of the time.
We were trying to bring together everything and categorize things in a way that made sense with the Sims traits and responses to the food in mind.
The updated recipe UI isn't the only thing coming to the base game alongside this pack. Hashtag free the cupcakes. Get ready to cook cupcakes in the comfort of your own oven rather than the cupcake machine.
For this pack, I mostly worked on cute accessories and casual clothes for your foodie Sims. There's a whisk-themed set of earrings and necklace. I'm really fond of this jumpsuit combo I made because it's definitely something I would wear in real life.
We've had so much fun developing this pack, and we have put a lot of heart into each of its features. We hope you enjoy the experience of becoming a home chef. Thank you so much for tuning into our first look. And now, here's a little sneak peek.
Seneke, Belindi, Verbi Ibsabindo, Yabo.
Waffles, so good. Looks like pancakes. Not you, Bob. I'm finally getting the competition they deserve. The Sims 4 Home Chef Hustle trailer reveals this Thursday, September 14th at 8 a.m. Pacific on the Sims YouTube channel. And The Sims 4 isn't done just yet. This season is all about the hustle. So the team has been bustling to not only deliver a new stuff pack, but provide a bit more to the list of content this season. Check it out.
So we're back on the bed for another S'more Lore, where we bite into the many histories and mysteries of the Sims series, and today is all about Johnny Zest and the Landgrab lineage.
some more lore. You know, the estranged member of the Landgraf family and everyone's second favorite Nubu daddy, all because he dropped out of school to become a comedian. But before we go more into Johnny, let's dive into the Landgraf lineage for some context. The Landgrafs don't have the best reputation. Some are known for being quite evil. But even with the family tree dating back to the original Sims, their history isn't totally clear. We do know it started with the medieval Demetrius and Dacian? And it's no secret that the Landgrafs are rich. They're rich, like old money rich. But they didn't get there without being sketchy. Ever wonder how they got all that money? Well, their name tells us a lot. Landgraf, as in grabbing up land. The Landgrafs always have mansions. From the Blue Water Village home, to Summerhill Court, to Chateau de Landgraf Tomb, and the Desert Oasis Mansion, you know, just to name a few. Okay, so let's get back to Johnny's ass. How is he related to the Landgrafs anyway? Johnny doesn't appear until The Sims 4 in Oasis Springs, where we never see him living with the family. And he doesn't even have the same last name, although he does go by his stage name. But still, what's his connection? Is he Nancy's son from an affair? A long-lost relative? Does Joffrey know? All we know is that after Johnny was disowned and went broke, he set out to get sweet revenge on his family by making some furniture out of materials from their construction site. Maybe stick to comedy, Johnny. So it begs the question, will the Landgrafs ever invite Johnny back into their family? Will we ever find out how he is even related to them in the first place? Who knows? But maybe as this universe continues to grow, we'll discover the truth, and if we do, we'll enjoy another s'more while looking more into the lore of this shady household.
Sul Sul, I'm Subaru Pedro, and I'm back to tell you about what's coming next in The Sims Mobile. So let's get to it. We're celebrating Halloween, 100 years of Hollywood, and a brand new story that revolves around a garden gnome and a bickering couple. So make sure to check it out. And there's more awesome stuff waiting for you, so make sure to download The Sims Mobile today. And now, let's take a look at what's coming next in The Sims Freeplay. We're celebrating Day of the Dead. Your Sims can feast, drink, dance, and play music with their loved ones. Special thanks to our EA creator, Michiro, for suggesting this festive theme. Also, don't forget to check out our new update, Pastel Pastimes, with incredible items and outfits featuring soft and dreamy hues. So make sure to download The Sims Freeplay and experience all this goodness. And now, back to you, Mercy.
Simlish, word of the day. Yeah. All right, before we continue, it's time for a new Simlish word of the day to add to your ever-growing dictionary. My goal is to have you all fluent in Simlish, so let's learn the second most important phrase you'll need to know next to Sul Sul, which is Yavhugaru. This means I'm hungry, a term I often use to let my bosses know that it's time for a break. For example, hey boss, with all this food around me, Yavhugaru, so I'm gonna take a lunch break after this, courtesy of The Sims. Okay, I'm super excited to have The Sims Queen Mother herself, Lindsay Pearson, back today to chat with me about Project Rene and the future of The Sims. Sul Sul, Lindsay.
Hey, Mercy. I am very excited to be here today. And Sul Sul to our community. I am thrilled to be back and sharing what we are working on. I think it's a really good time to be playing The Sims.
Oh, 100%. Maybe it's just the way I play, but my game really hits different each time. Can you tell us more about how your experience over the years is shaping and setting the stage for Project Rene?
Yeah, over the years, you've seen us introduce so many versions of Sims experiences, from The Sims to The Sims Online, The Sims Castaway, The Sims Medieval, Herbs. So we're always looking for ways to bring The Sims to more players and keep that charming character and creation center at the heart of what we make. What must we preserve to make this still a Sims game? And what can we do in this game that we couldn't do before?
Right. So during the last episode of Behind the Sims, the team shared a look at a whole lot of work in progress with Project Rene. Is that how you're trying to find that new vibe?
Exactly. And with Project Rene, we want to do things from the start that The Sims hasn't ever done and try to do familiar things in a new way. So Project Rene will be a new way to play The Sims. Now, we've shared a few of those differences that we're already exploring, such as the ability to play with friends and across devices, and we can't wait to show you more of the gameplay itself. And I'm really excited to be building this new and different approach. Project Rene and The Sims 4 are gonna continue to exist side by side. We plan to support both at the same time, and we're gonna continue to bring even more exciting content to The Sims 4 for the foreseeable future.
Don't get me wrong, I'm super invested in my Sims 4 storylines, but thinking about the different opportunities we've seen in like The Sims Castaway and Herbs, which, by the way, one of my absolute favorites, it just makes me excited to think about how I'll pop into Project Rene to play with friends.
We want to make it super easy for your friends to come and join you. So we'll actually have more to share about what multiplayer will look like in Project Rene in the year ahead, but I want to talk about one way specifically that we're going to make it as easy as possible to join. So we intend for Project Rene to be free to download, and that means that when it's ready and fully open to our players, you'll be able to join and play and explore Project Rene without a subscription, without core game purchase, or energy mechanics. So we want it to be easy for you to invite or join with a friend, and that means extending an open invitation for everyone to play.
Really bombastic side eye.
We're developing this game in a different way, and we're bringing everyone along with us, and that means a lot of different phases of development, which can include everything from closed invites and small public tests to large-scale early access options. And yes, when Project Rene is ready, it'll be available to download for free.
So what does that mean for content in the game, like updates?
We want to focus on building something strong and cohesive from the start. So it definitely won't start with everything you have in The Sims 4, but we're going to add new experiences and content to Project Rene over time.
Okay, so what might that look like? We talking DLC, packs?
Well, beyond regular updates to the core game, we will sell content and packs, but we want to change that mix a little bit. So let me give you a theoretical example. In The Sims 4, the only way to experience any weather was if you purchased seasons, right? Now in Project Rene, we might introduce basic weather to the core game for free for everybody. And then a pack for purchase might be focused on winter sports and could include activities like ice dancing or a snowman building competition. So building this way means that down the line, we could use wind or rain or clouds for other pack themes as well. Now it's a little early to know exactly where we'll draw the lines, but it's important for us to lower those barriers to play and give everyone the broadest shared systems because that feels like the best foundation to grow from.
Really interesting. I will definitely need to think about this some more, and I'll need to review this all again on the Sims Newsroom. Shout out to that team for the recap.
So as we shared last time, we are still exploring a lot of different ideas, and we haven't settled on all the details of everything, but it's important for us to keep sharing, so stay tuned for more updates as we go. But for now, how about a quick summary? So Project Rene and other Sims games, including The Sims 4, will coexist for the foreseeable future. It means Project Rene is not setting out to replace your current awesome Sims experiences. And because we want everyone to join the Sims party when it's ready, Project Rene will be free to download.
Well, thank you so much for your time, Queen Mother. I can't wait to keep learning more about Project Rene, so know that you are always welcomed on our couch.
Thank you, Mercy. Pleasure to be here.
This is a top secret announcement. The Sims is officially putting out merch, you know, so you can show off looks while showing the world your Simmer status. Now, you know that I already know. And no, this won't be like past and we're taking it slow to give you the merch you deserve, so it'll be available later this year. But while we're here, let's take a little peek, shall we? Omza glad. It's the perfect gift for that special someone. You know, Nancy doesn't do cheap, so this is gonna be well made. Someone give me the motherlode cheat, because I'm going ham. I swear, it's gonna be awesome.
That's it for today. Remember to subscribe to The Sims YouTube channel and follow The Sims Freeplay, and The Sims Mobile across social to keep up to date on the latest news and the next Behind The Sims. Until next time, dog dog!
5A, take one.
It's kind of
take three.
Yeah.
Next to Sul Sul, which is... Okay, I'm super excited to have The Sims Queen... I bit my tongue. It's gonna be awesome. Jesus! Oops, sorry. I'm gonna do that again. Hold on. The new season is starting, and if you're like me, you're hot.